Processing of copper is a complicated process that begins with mining of the ore. The most common types of ores are copper oxide ores and copper sulfide ores. The process of extracting pure copper from ore varies according to the type of ore. Oxide ores are generally processed using hydrometallurgy and sulfide ores are generally processed using pyrometallurgy. Copper sulfide ores are typically the most profitable copper ores because they have high copper content. The most common sulfide ore is chalcopyrite. Chalcopyrite is also known as copper pyrite or yellow copper, etc. There are several steps involved in making of pure copper, but in this video, we are going to see 7 basic steps. Mining the ore, grinding, froth flotation, roasting, smelting, besmerization, electrolytic refining. The first step in making of copper is mining raw material. Most sulfide ores are taken from huge open pit mines by drilling and blasting with explosives, and the ore is transported using giant dump trucks. Now step 2, grinding. In grinding, the ore is crushed in a series of cone crushers to break the large rocks of ore into smaller pieces, and the crushed ore is then grounded even smaller by using ball mills. In ball mills, the ore is mixed with water that converts the powdered ore into slurry. This slurry is a mix of valuable copper, waste rock called gangue, and other impurities. Now step 3, froth flotation. The slurry is placed in a tank and a process called froth flotation is used to separate the copper minerals from the waste material. Chemical reagents called collectors are added to the slurry. These reagents make the copper particles hydrophobic or waterproof, and a liquid called frother is also added. Pine oil or long chain alcohols are often used as frothers. Then air is blown into the bottom of the tank to create bubbles, which rise to the surface, taking the waterproof copper sulfide particles along. The froth of the copper-rich bubbles at the top of the tank is then skimmed off for further processing. The waste material sinks to the bottom of the tank, is removed or disposed. Now step 4, roasting. This is where the chemical reaction starts. In roasting, the concentrated ore is heated in a reverberatory furnace by passing excess of air. During roasting, moisture and the volatile impurities like sulfur, phosphorus, arsenic, etc. are removed as volatile oxides. Now step 5, smelting. Now the copper concentrate is fed into a furnace along with silica material called a flux. Flux is added to the ore to make it melt more easily. Oxygen-enriched air is forced into the furnace to combust with fuel oil. The copper concentrate and flux melt and collected in bottom of the furnace. Much of the impurities like iron chemically combines with flux to form a slag, which is skimmed off from the surface of the molten material. Much of the sulfur in the ore combines with oxygen to form sulfur dioxide. And the remaining molten material in the bottom of the furnace is called matte. It contains about 60% copper by weight. Now step 6, besmerization. The molten matte is drawn from the smelting furnace and poured in a second furnace called Bessemer converter. In this method, the air is blown into the molten copper material. The silica flux reacts with the remaining iron to form a slag, and the oxygen reacts with the sulfur to form sulfur dioxide. The resulting molten material contains about 98 to 99% copper by weight, and it is called copper blister. Now step 7, electrolytic refining. The molten copper is poured into the molds to form large electrical anodes, which acts as positive terminals for electrolytic refining process. Each copper anode is placed in individual tanks or cells, and another sheet of pure copper is placed on the opposite end of the tank to act as the cathode or negative terminal. The tank is filled with acidic copper sulfate solution, which acts as an electrical conductor between the anode and cathode. When electric current is passed through the terminals, the copper is stripped off from the anode and it is deposited on the cathode. Most of the remaining impurities form as slime at the bottom of the tank. After completing the process, current is turned off and the cathodes are removed. The cathodes now weigh about approximately 130 kg or 99.95 to 99.99% pure copper. Next, the copper cathodes are melted and cast as ingots, billets or rods, etc. depending on the final usage. And these are some of the basic steps for making pure copper from copper sulfide ores.